All right, so deadlift, another one where the technique or the positions are going to change or be specific to different sports. There's a big difference between a powerlifting deadlift, an Olympic weightlifting deadlift, and then from there, you know, different focus points in a performance setting. So for this one here, just kind of looking at the natural or standard deadlift, which for me is actually a sumo dead, but turning around here. The setup for me is going to be much wider than most. Most of you are going to be able to set up maybe just outside of hip width, just about shoulder width, foot distance. But if you have shitty mobility and flexibility like me, you'll come out a little bit wider. In either case, what our goal here is to try to move the bar as one collective unit. The biggest mistake that we see on the deadlift is people starting down here and then pushing the hips up and away and still having their chest facing the ground. We need hips and shoulders to rise and fall together. Everything is moving as one. This position here is obviously putting a tremendous amount of stress on the low back and the spine, but on top of that, it's also just a very inefficient pattern. When we see that, we see a start, stop, and then a start, stop. We're losing our momentum as we're going through the pattern. So with the deadlift, what we want to look at again is pushing the ground away and having everything synchronized as it's coming up. We're thinking about pushing the ground away. Even though this is commonly associated as a pull movement, I like to think push the ground away because I think it helps to get both some quad activation, but then also keeping the chest a little bit more upright, keeping the lats involved as we're coming up to the top.